A small fire keeps them warm.
I wrap up in a wool blanket. I sleep usually around a roading park.
In the 60s, we sent them to Vietnam.
Some people don't like it when they see you on the street like that because it bothers them.
They were young and healthy. Now they struggle to stay alive.
Stealing and hustling and panhandling and begging and borrowing.
Over a third of all homeless are veterans.
And I scrounge up aluminum cans and take them to the recycler so I can get a few dollars so I can go get a Big Mac.
Experts blame post-traumatic stress syndrome or shell shock.
I don't believe they were given enough counseling on how to deal with the pressures and stress of being actual in war.
Because I wasn't really familiar with the VA at that time, so I probably would have saved my situation as it presented itself to him.
And veterans continue to fall through the cracks.
From all branches of the service, they have good educations and have trades behind them, and they still can't find work.
They will train you. They will and teach you all kinds of survival techniques.
But they won't teach you how to survive once you're out.
That's one of the things that's really puzzling to me. While you're in the service and you're serving the country, they will do everything for you. But once you leave, there's not a support group or network.
Once they're out of the military, they face unemployment, homelessness, divorce, sometimes drug addiction. Then they have to struggle to survive.
Things didn't turn out the way I expected. I started hanging around the people that I didn't need to be hanging around with, and things were put in front of me, and due to my depressed state of mind and everything, I experimented.
For former Marine Dwayne Wilson, escape meant drugs.
I didn't know how to live life anymore because things just wasn't going the way I figured they should. As me being a veteran and everything, I just thought that more doors would open, but it seemed like more were closing.
How come our government, that spends so much money to help needy people in other countries, and yet many people like me and many others that were vets, we can't seem to qualify for training programs so that we can be trained for the jobs that are available.
It's hard to find work without an address when you're out in the streets.
Help us. We need it.
Programs, training.
Yeah, we need all the help we can get, because a lot of us are in dire need.
Paul Chedurgian, 47, on Your Side News.